Good morning to everyone. Once again, welcome to social science class. In this class, we are going to see about history. In the history, we are going to see the upcoming chapter. Please continue with me. Here, chapter number 8, the name of the chapter is Vital Villages and Thriving Towns. In this chapter, we are going to see the following points from this topic. So, topics are iron tools and agriculture. Next topic, who lived in the villages? Third, finding out about the cities, their stories, travelers, sculpture and archaeology. So these following topics we are going to see in the part 1 presentation of chapter number 8. Iron tool and agriculture. First we are going to see iron tools and agriculture. We often take the use of iron for granted today. So, as we are taking the iron use as a granted one, but the history of iron we are going to move in that. Things made of iron and steel are a part of our daily lives. The use of iron began in the subcontinent around 3000 years ago. Some of the largest collection of the iron tools and weapons were found in the megalithic burials above, which already we had seen in the chapter number 4. So, around 2500 years ago, there is evidence of growing use of iron tools. These include axes for clearing the forest and iron plowshare. As we had seen in chapter number 5, the plowshare was useful for increasing agriculture production. So, dear cadets, here we are seeing the chapter number 8. In that, iron tools in the textbook on page number 87 from the old book, it's given here. Okay, so you please refer it. Next, other steps to increase production. Irrigation, the king and the kingdom you have been reading about could not have been existing without the support of flourishing wheat. Why new tools and the system of transplantation? In chapter number 5, increased production, irrigation was also used. Irrigation works that were built during this time include canal, well, tank, artificial lake. So here, in this point, we are going to see first the iron tool, the use of iron to making different tools which are helpful in agriculture. Second point, irrigation. Irrigation means giving water to the crops which they are growing. Next, if you look at the chart, you will find that some of the stages in the construction of irrigation works are mentioned. So, where is the chart? In the upcoming slide, we are going to see that chart. Okay, so the chart is focusing upon few fill in the blanks and rest by using the following phrases. 1, 2, 3, 4, you have to use it, right? And that is given here. Here it is. So, you have to write in the textbook only. In the textbook only, you have to fill up these only. Okay? Please see it. It's speaking about 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th and 9th. How it's moving. So one, you have to pick up it and you have to place. Right? Just the king needed money for the army, palaces, fort. They demand taxes from farmer. So which one will come? So farmers has to increase the production to pay the tax. It should be the third one. Okay? So like that, you have to place. From these points, you have to pick up one sentence and place here the blanks. In the textbook, you have to do it. Next, who lived in the villages? Now we are going to see who were the people, those who were living in the village, right? We are going to see. So in that, we are going to see about the Vellalar, Ujjavars, right? Adimai and all. There were at least of 3 different kinds of people living in the most villages in the southern and the northern parts of subcontinent. In Tamil region, the large landlords were known as Vellalar. Right? In Tamil region, the large landlord were named by Vellalar. Next, ordinary ploughmen were known as Ujjavars. and landless laborers including slaves were known as Kadisiya or Adimai. Next, in the north part, the village headman was known as Gram Bhojka. Usually, the men from the same family held a position for generation and generation. In other words, the post was hereditary. That means, after father, the son is going to take that position. Then the Gram Bhojka was often the largest landlord generally. He had slaves and hard workers to cultivate the land. Besides, as he was also powerful, and the king often used to give him to collect the taxes from the village. Then he also functioned as a judge and sometimes as a policeman in the particular village. Next, apart from the Gram Bhojka, there were other independent powers who were known as Grihapatis. So these Grihapatis were most were smaller landlords, and they were often men and women such as Das and Kammakaras, who did not have their own land piece and had earned a living working on the field owned by others. In most villages, there were also some craft persons such as blacksmith, potter, carpenter, and weaver. So, dear carers, already we have seen how the society was bifurcated, how the one person was the head, right, was known as Nallalar, then Ujavas, and then Adimai. Then in the northern part, we had seen about that the Gram Bhojka is there, Grihapati is there, or Das or Dasis or Kammakara. Okay, next. Finding out about the city, stories, travelers, cultures and archaeology. You may have heard of the stories of Jatakas. These were the stories were probably composed by the ordinary peoples and then written down and preserved by the Buddhist monks. Here in a part of Jataka story which tells us how a poor man gradually become rich. So in this story you can understand about how a poor man is becoming rich. Okay, so the story is given in the textbook. Here your homework is that you have to read this story, right? This story, the clever poor man. Okay, and we have to understand how the poor man gradually become rich. We can use other kind of evidence to find out about the life in some of these early cities. Sculptures, carved scenes despite peoples living in the towns and villages, as well as in the forest. Many of these sculptures were used to decorate railing, pillars and gateways of buildings that were visited by the people. Next, many of the cities that developed from 2500 years ago were capitals of Mahajanapadas, and already we had learned in chapter number 5. As we had seen, some of the cities were surrounded by the massive fortification. Already we had seen why Mahajanapadas were fortifying their areas, right? Or they used to build fort or fortification for their own. In many cities, archaeologists have found the row pots, right, ceramics, ring, arranged one on top of the other, and these are known as ring well. The photograph is placed in the textbook, you can see it. These seems to be have been used as a toilet in some cases and as a drain from and garbage dump. These ring wells are usually found in individual houses. Next, we have hardly any remains of palaces, markets or homes of ordinary people. Perhaps some of it is discovered by archaeologists. Others made of wood, mud, brick and thatch may not have been survived. Another way of finding about the early cities in the form of account of sailors and travelers who visited them. One of the most detailed accounts that has been founded was the unknown Greek sailor. He described all the forts he visited. Find Bharuj on map number 7 on page number 105 and then read the description of the city. Right? You have to find out in the map and you have to see the description. Next, we are ending this In the next part, we are going to see about the more story from this chapter, and we are going to do the question answers. Till then, be safe and secure at your home. Jai Hind.